program of action and especially the vocational education part of the program of action, because when you will see the program of action document, you will find that there are several sections. The section is for the secondary education also, the section is for the higher education also, section is for the vocational education as well, and so there are several sections in the program of action document. So when we will see that the vocational education part, first this document starts with the management part of the vocational education, means how it will be managed, because it says that the different level of education, even the secondary, senior secondary, tertiary, higher education will be vocationalized in the view with the demand and supply of the industry, and it will be diversified as well also, that we had discussed. So this document talks that in order to achieve the quality in the vocational education, it must be properly managed. And it talks about the management at a national level, management at a even the state level, district level, local level, 3-4 layers of management this document used to talk. And at a national level, for the quality management of the vocational education, it talks that there will be a council will be constituted under the Ministry of Education, and with the coordination with the Ministry of Planning. This council will be constituted, named as the Joint Council of Vocational Education, JCVE. Joint Council means it is a joint venture, joint council of two ministry. One is the Education Ministry, another one is the Ministry of Planning. So that's why it talks about the Joint Council of Educational Management. It will be constituted, who will take care the quality, quantity means making the availability of the vocational education and its quality throughout the country. So this council will take care. Apart from that, the Council of Vocational Education, a Bureau of Vocational Education will be also established in the Ministry of Education. Actually, that time the Ministry of Education was again renamed as a Ministry of Human Resource and Development, which is again renamed as a Ministry of Education, as we know, which will support, means the Bureau will support the Secretariat support to the Council of Vocational Education, JCVE. Secretariat support means the assisting support, like that the policy level decision, like that the implementation mechanism, like that the support will be provided by the Bureau of Vocational Education. And not only that Secretariat support is required, but here also research and development in the area of vocational education, preparing the curriculum, preparing the syllabus, preparing the learning material was also required, and that liability is given to the NCERT. Because in the previous discussion I have told you that there was one organization named as a Pandit Sundarlal Sarma National Institute of Vocational Education, that was brought out under the NCERT in 1961, when the NCERT was framed. Okay, so that even when you will see the history of that is the CIET, Central Institute of Education Technology. It was also an independent body at that time, means before the 1961. Even when you will find the NIE, National Institute of Education, which is in the Delhi, in the campus of NCERT, it was also independent organization. So all those things was brought under the umbrella of NCERT with the establishment of NCERT. Okay. So the NCERT has given through its Department of Vocational Education for conducting research and development, preparing the academic support, preparing the curriculum, preparing the assessment tool, like kind of a thing the NCERT was given. So that was the structure at proposed by the POA at a national level. At a regional level, the Regional College of Education of NCERT, nowadays we know it as RIE, hai na? Earlier the same was existing as a Regional College of Education, RCE. So they have been given the responsibility for the research and development, preparing the curriculum, organizing a model course for the vocational teachers training. It was given the responsibility to the RCE, now it is a RIE. Okay, so they have been given the responsibility. Together with that, the Board of Apprenticeship Training was also constituted, and they have been given the responsibility of organizing and making available the training courses as per the need and requirement of the students in that region. Okay, even at the state level, as like that we had seen that JCVE, it was established at a national level. At a state level, SCVE was established, State Council of Vocational Education. Okay, the function responsibility was same as the JCVE, as we have seen earlier. Even at a state level, directorate of within the Directorate of Education in each and every state and UT is administrative support mechanism was established in each state. And likewise, we have seen the NCERT have been given a responsibility for providing research and development at a national and a regional level. Like that, SCERT also given a responsibility of providing research and development activities at a state level. So these are the very theoretical things. At a district level also, District Vocational Education Committee was constituted. Okay, it was suggested and it was constituted also to take care the district level need of vocational education. Okay, so that they were taking care. Even school level also, when senior staff, in the most of the case the headmaster or the vocational course coordinator was taken responsibility to coordinate the vocational education program for the school level students. So that the responsibility was given. Apart from that, this document also talks about the essentials for the successful vocational program. Is what should be the essential component present for the successful organization and a completion of a vocational education. The first thing that in this discussion we will see that whenever we talk about the vocational education, the vocational education is always linked with the employability of the candidates who are coming out of the vocational education center or a school. What will be their employability? So employability can be ensured with the two, three things. One thing is that the quality of education. Another thing is the credibility of the education that you are imparting. What is the credibility? How much it is credible? How much it have a authentic impact among the people about the quality of the vocational education? So that needs to be established, because if you don't have a quality, if you don't have a relevance, if the vocational education that you are imparting is not acceptable, it is not acceptable, acceptability is less, credibility is less, then it will be difficult to get the student for the vocational education. Because if it will be not there, a student will be not getting the employment opportunity. So if they won't get the employment opportunity, so obviously the demand will be less and you won't get the student. So that was assured in this program of action. Another was that education employment linkage should be family established. Means the kind of educational program, vocational education program that you are or the educational institute is organizing, it must be linked with the industry. If it is not linked with the industry, then it is difficult to get the student for that. Chinu Smita Nayak, you are joining so late. Chinu Smita just now she joined. Okay, so no problem. So here the linkage between the education, vocational education, and the employment that is there, it must be formally established. Otherwise the student, those who will be coming out of the vocational education, they won't get the employment opportunity, and the further the result will be that the other student will be demotivated from coming to the vocational education programs. Okay, then because this document also talks about the you can say that the credibility, relevance, acceptability, quality of the vocational education. So the quality, credibility, and acceptability of the vocational education can be established by the providing sound academic support, physical infrastructure, and the facilities available there. So that's why it talks about providing adequate infrastructure. Adequate infrastructure in terms of the classroom, in terms of the support material, in terms of the teachers, even in terms of the other required things like a laboratory, like a library, that kind of a thing. The infrastructure must be sound so that the quality, you can say that the quality person that the trainee will be coming out of that. So that will be there. Okay, so and it is also emphasized in this document that the support, funding support, that is the monetary support to the institution, should be extended at least for the period of 5 to 10 years. Why? Because if that type of a fund will be supported to the institute, then they will be able to develop a sound infrastructure for the institute. And if the sound infrastructure will be there, so it will help them for sustaining the institute, because sustainability of the institute was also one of the burning issue, that how the institute will be sustained Okay. And it also talks about that providing training as a both a pre-service and a in-service to the teachers, because here we are talking about the quality, and we know that the in the present times the technology changes at a very rapid step. So the teachers who are working there, they also needs to be updated with the latest trend and technology. So for that both provision was there, that is in service and pre-service training of teachers. I think it has come here, it will be there. Pre-service and in-service training of teachers. Then it was also provision for the effective management of a structure, that is the vocational structure at center level, state or a UT level, and a district level, school level, like that. One that very means important issue that was discussed in the POA, you will also find that the one was that the curriculum development and consultation with the employers, because the main motive of providing a vocational education was to provide an employment opportunity. So how the employment opportunity will be ensured if the courses will be organized in consultation with the industry, means what are their requirement. So it talks about that courses that will be organized at a regional level or a district level or a state level, it must be in consultation with the industries. The second thing which it talks about is that the provision for equivalence among the vocational, technical, and academic courses. It is very important, and it is a very much that the issue that needs immediate attention at that time. Because what happens, suppose that there is a 2-3 person, I will take one example. That suppose that the 2 person both have come out of the 10th examination, 10th board. One student has taken the vocational stream, means he went or she went for the ITI or a polytechnic. Another one went for the plus two in science. Another one went for the plus two in arts. So all they have went in the different stream. So the value of their certificate must be same in order to assure the vertical mobility of the person's academic growth, vertical mobility. Like that, when we pass the board examination, so we have to another opportunity as a plus two, then another opportunity as a graduation, then the post graduation, then the MPhil, then the PhD. Nowadays, with the Education Policy 2020, this MPhil is discarded. So let it be the MPhil, but there is a vertical movement. Suppose that those who one did a vocational training, that is ITI after 10th, and if they don't have a scope for the vertical movement, then what they will do? So there must be a scope for the vertical movement. There must be a scope for pursuing the higher degree courses and the equivalence of those degree with the others. That's why when you will find that when you will pursue ITI or when you will pursue plus two in arts, both are equivalent, means at term of a label they are equivalent courses. So that is the one of the important thing, and that's why when you will find that generally, for example, you can see that generally for entering to the engineering courses, suppose that the BTech, the qualification is plus 2, okay. But what about the person who have did a polytechnic? Polytechnic after 10th board, so how they will go in that direction? So if you have did a polytechnic, directly you can enter in the second year of BTech. So that is the equivalence to provide the horizontal mobility. If that horizontal mobility will be not there, then the student will be demotivated, because they will understand that as and when you will finish that course, there is no scope of a horizontal mobility. So that was also ensured in this document. Then it also talks about that the pre-service training for the vocational teacher, that was in the present moment, means at the 90s, time of the 90s, okay. So it was also non-existence, means there was a no vocational teachers training course was existence, and in service training was also very much not adequate. So it was also not adequate, and the component of a vocational teachers was also not available in the desired number. The point of saying is that there was a not availability of a pre-service teacher training program, there was a inadequate availability of a in-service teacher training program, and there was also unavailability of a competent vocational teacher in a desired number, means the amount of a teacher we were requiring. So what was happening? It was directly adversely affecting the vocational education program, because the pre-service teacher program was not there, in-service teacher program was not adequate, and the number was also not sufficient. That's why it suggests that organizing teacher training programs, establishing a teacher training institute for the vocational education. And that's why you will find that there is a institute established, NITTIR, I nahi hai sahab, NITTIR, National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research. It is in Kolkata, another one is Chennai, there is in Bhopal also. So whenever you will visit the Kolkata, you can see that, try to visit that. They are taking care the training of a vocational teachers. Suppose that you will be appointed in the polytechnic college, so your training will be there. They used to take care the research and development part in that area. And it also, this is a very factual data, so I need not discuss that. They also say that by the end of 8th 5-year plan, 1600 teachers will be given a pre-service training, because that the unavailability of the teachers. It also talks that the training of a teacher, vocational teacher, will be taken care by the NCERT, CIVE, DIETS, SCERT, like that. And those who are related with the medical practices, so the Medical Council of India, Medical Institutes Research Laboratory, they will take care their training part. And it also says that the 12,000 teachers will receive the in-service teacher training by this organization. Another, the last one that we will see here, that is the measure facilitating employment, means what are the measures have been taken to facilitate the employment, because the employment is the one of the major ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग वोकेशनल एजुकेशन. सो द फर्स्ट इज दैट द इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ अ सर्टिफिकेट दैट वी हैव सीन दैट देयर शुड बी अ इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ अ सर्टिफिकेट फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग द वर्टिकल मोबिलिटी. सपोज दैट आई वॉन्ट टू परस्यू द हायर एजुकेशन, सो देयर शुड बी अ चांस. देयर वॉज अनदर थिंग लाइक दैट द मोडिफाइंग द रिक्रूटमेंट रूल as per, because we have seen that one case we have seen when we were discussing the NPE 86, that some of the person who were competent enough but without the formal degree, so that it was modified that those people can also be recruited. That when we were discussing the delinking degree from the job, that time I have discussed. So here also there is a need for the modification in the recruitment rule. Okay, so that those who are coming out of the vocational education, they will be getting the employment opportunity. Another one, I think I have written two times the vocational education. There is also requirement of providing the vocational guidance. Even nowadays also, I think, even in the present time also, I think that vocational guidance is one of the important thing that must be given to the school going children, because majority of them, they don't want, they don't know that what are the different opportunities are available after 10th or after 12th or after graduation. And what are the different education qualification is required? Suppose that a student don't know that after plus two they either they can enter in the medical or they can enter in the engineering or they can go for the polytechnic or they can go for the merchant navy or they can go for the being a pilot or like that. So many options are there, but they don't know what are the courses that they should be enrolled, what are the courses required for those type of vocation. They don't know, and in absence of the proper guidance, they are not getting a proper employment opportunity. It is also there that a majority of students are entering in a particular job, like that there was a time when the student was coming out of the plus two science, they were either interested to enter in the medical or in the engineering. So it is due to the absence of a vocational guidance. Okay. So I think that was all about that I wanted to talk in the today class. However, when we will talk about the POA and its particularly to the vocational education, you will find that a lot of a thing is given, and all the thing is not possible even to talk in the class, but some of the major thing I have talked in this class. So now this is the time for question answer session. Any kind of a question or anything, if you have, you can put your question now. Yes, please, any question? Hello. Acha. So I am getting one question, and meanwhile you should also talk about the any kind of a question you are having. You can post in the chat box. Tanuj is saying, according to the 12th fifth year plan, okay, less than 5% receive a formal vocational education. Is it government spent less money regarding vocational education? Yes, the data you are citing is correct, and even though you don't have a data, okay, suppose that I have not seen the 12 year plan ka report, I have not seen, I don't know what is the percentage. You just see in and around you, you will find that the very less percent of a student are enrolled in the vocational education, and they are getting vocational education even at a 10th level. because it talks about the secondary education also. Secondary education is the 9 and 10. You will find very less number of a student is getting vocational education at a secondary level. At a senior secondary level, you will find comparatively more. I am not telling it is a more, comparatively more, because some of the students are in the ITI and the polytechnic, and the other also like nurse training and midwife training, like that they are, but you will find that very less number of students are there. Okay, the reason is multiple. One is that the support from the government, some support in terms of the mechanism support, structural support, and the monetary support also, it is less. You will find that a good polytechnic college, good ITI college availability is very less. So it is there. Another thing is that I was talking about the vocational guidance. Vocational guidance is also not being given to the student in a school, because there is no counselor. So they are not given vocational guidance. So they are ignorant of choosing that in which course they should go. Okay, so that is the also one of the reason. Another reason is that the employment opportunity. Nowadays, when you will find that employment opportunity for the polytechnic is very less, it also have a multiple reason. One reason is that a lot of engineering colleges was established, because we must see the demand and supply. Hana? Because if you will produce more than the demand, it's a common rule of economics. If the production will be more than the demand, its value will be less. So instead of a polytechnic, means that the diploma candidate, the company are getting a graduate candidate, and they are ready to work in a low salary also, because the supply is more, so obviously salary will get below. So their demand become very less. So this is also one of the reason. Okay, and similarly, when you will try to find the demand and supply kind of a relation for the teacher education, you can see the detailed report prepared by the NCTE in the NCTE website, the demand and supply of a teacher in a different states. For sake of example, I will tell you that in some of the state, the production of a AMED candidate is more than the demand. Then in those state, you will find that the candidates are working at 10,000, 12,000 per month also after doing AMED. So it is the imbalance between the demand and supply, and particularly when we see that it has a variety of a reason. Financial reason is also there, mechanical reason is also there, and that demand and supply reason is also there, vocational guidance is also there. The variety of reason is there. There is no single reason. Okay, Tanus, is it clear to you?
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else apart from that?
हेलो सर.
हाँ, यस प्लीज
सर. अभी जो एनपी 2020 के अनुसार जो नया पॉलिसी है, मतलब 11 12 जुड़ गया है, तो वो इक्विवेलेंसी कैसे होगा इसके साथ? मतलब पॉलिटेक्निक की जो भी आईटीआई कर रहे हैं, वो 10th के बाद होता है, वो 10th के बाद होता है, तो वो भी स्कूल.
हाँ, यस, आई गॉट योर पॉइंट. बिकॉज वो 10th के बाद होता है, इसमें कैसे होगा? सी, अभी आप देखेंगे, मैं आई विल रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट यू शुड रीड द न्यूज़पेपर. क्वालिटी न्यूज़पेपर, नाउ अडेज आई कैन नॉट से दैट रीड एनी पर्टिकुलर और एनी सब स्टैंडर्ड न्यूज़पेपर, आई विल नॉट टेक द नेम, बट यू मस्ट हैव सीन इन द न्यूज़ दैट नाउ अडेज इवन द TRP इज मैनेज्ड. सो दैट्स वाई आई यूज टू से दैट्स यू ट्राई टू सी द सम ऑफ द गुड क्वालिटी न्यूज़पेपर एंड यू रीड द आर्टिकल. एक्चुअली दिस इज द ओनली द पॉलिसी, ठीक है, हाउ इट विल बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड मीन्स द मैकेनिज्म फॉर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इट इज बींग डिवाइज्ड, है ना, ये अभी इट हैज नॉट कम टू द फ्लोर. द मैकेनिज्म विल बी ब्रॉट आउट दैट हाउ वाई दे विल डू एंड वट विल बी द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन मैकेनिज्म दैट विल कम. सो एट दैट टाइम ऑल द थिंग्स विल बिकम मोर क्लियर. However, I have some of the conception about the things, but I think that it is not right time to share all those things, because government is yet to bring those mechanism. They will bring up, they will make some regulations like that. They will make like that. You think know that the UGC will be replaced, but still UGC is working. Means the other thing that will be bringed, it has been not established, mechanism has been not framed. So slowly it will take time, and that time it will become clear. So for the time being, polytechnics and all those structure will be there. When the new thing will come, then we will see that what will be their structure. Till now they have not brought the structure. So I think it is not a right time to comment. Okay. Is it okay to you? हाँ, because हाँ mechanism नहीं आया है ना, तो मैं अपने मन से बोलूँगा वो ठीक नहीं है. हाँ, it won't be good. Anything else? Okay. So shall we stop this class here?
Okay.
Yes.
So.
Yes.
Thank you for being with me in this session. Have a nice day.